Hello, my friends, and welcome to my channel. I'm Monica, and I'm back with another video with the Advent calendars review. As always, at the beginning of the month, we're gonna talk about a lot of products today. Anyway, at this point, my calendars are looking quite empty. It looks like we're gonna have two or three more months, and now we're done with them. It's gonna be about time because at the end of next month, they will post what's gonna be available for this year. Anyway, in the meantime, let's see what I have in this, because it's gonna be anyway a long video talking about all those products and picking up new products. I have a couple items in here that came before in other calendars, and we did a review for them in the past reviews in the last month, so I'm not gonna talk about them again. But anyway, I will start with the Body Shop Advent calendar, the red one, and I had four items in here. The first one was this beauty blender, and I do apologize because they look dirty. I just use them when I put on my makeup, and as I told you, if I'm looking like a rainbow, it's because I'm using in my makeup. At least I'm trying to use all the products that we have as makeup in the month. So was this beauty blender. It's $8. It's bouncy. I do like this beauty blender. I like the shape of this one, the flat part, and also the very pointy tip, because this one is great for concealer. So I did enjoy this one. I like it, and I do recommend it. The second one, it's the second product, it's a face mask, and this one is vitamin C glow sheet mask. This one, after 15 minutes, grumpy skin feels hydrated, awakened, and healthier. I do like them. I tried some different ones in the last reviews, and I did like them. The single problem that I have with their mask is the shape. I don't know, maybe my face is out of shape, or I don't know what happens, but it doesn't fit me very well. Actually, it's a little bit larger and not too short, but I'm fine with that. Anyway, I did enjoy this one, and I liked even more the one that I will show you in a little bit. But was a nice one, being a natural mask. This one is vegan with vitamin C and aloe vera. You're supposed to keep this one for 15 minutes. Next product in here, it's a body butter, and this one is the British Rose body butter. We talked about those products before in the last reviews. I like the formula, I like the scent. They those are very well known products from the Body Shop. Always enjoy using them, and I have quite a big collection now in all kind of sizes, from small sizes to big sizes, so I always like to use them, and I recommend. And the last one is a product that we had before, is the Shine Lip Liquid in Sherry Gum 04. I will swatch this one for you. Looks really pretty on the lips. It's a nice color. It came in another calendar, still from the Body Shop before, so I'm not gonna insist about this one, but has a really nice shine. And I do recommend this one. Comes in other shades, of course, and it's $10. The next calendar is the Body Shop, the green one, the Ultimate, which was the bigger one. And in here we have a nice shadow brush. In previous years, we got a spoolie in each advent calendar for the brows. Now we got this eyeshadow, and I really like it. Here is the handle for this one. I like this one to use it with eyeshadows that you're supposed to apply by tapping them on the eyelid, not blending. And this one worked perfect with those kind of eyeshadows that are kind of... are kind of have like a crumbly formula, not that the one that spreads very well, it's just the one that you're supposed to press, and this one works really well for that. So I like the brush. Then we had in here another face mask, and this one is the Youth Concentrate Sheet Mask with instant hydration after 15 minutes, fresher, bouncer, healthier, with 3 plant stem cells, edelweiss, probably I'm not saying that right, from the Italian Alps, Sea Holly, and something marine. from the British coast. So anyway, I like this one more. It says that this one had a ton of serum. It says it has that well-known youth concentrate from them, and it's showed here on the back. I like this one more than the vitamin C one. The serum felt really nice on the skin, so I do recommend that one. Then we have this mist, and this one is the Rose Dewy Glow Face Mist. I finished this one, and I have another one empty from the 50 Shades of Pink Project Pan. I really like this one, smells pretty well, and it's very hydrating, so I do recommend this one. Probably it's a product that I will buy again. When I'll buy the advent calendars, probably I'm gonna add a couple items that I tried in this year advent calendar and I like them, like the bed bombs and this mist, if will come again. I don't know if this one was probably was I don't think was a limited edition because I found the price for this one on their website, so it's still available. I would like to buy this one again. Then the next product in here was a shower gel, and this one was the warm vanilla shower gel. Was a limited edition one because I didn't see this one on their website. Was very creamy as formula, and it smelled really, really nice and pleasant. So I did enjoy them. I like to switch between them because I have many of them in deluxe samples, and I always try to switch between the scents. But this one was creamy, was not quite a clear gel, was more like a cream, but nice product. Then we have, and of course I will leave up there, I don't know, here or here, I will leave the quantities that I found and the prices. So next calendar was the glossy box, and that one came with a cream from First Aid Beauty. This is Ultra Repair Cream. I think it's the first time, no, the second time when I'm trying a product from the brand. And this one used to help hydrate dry, patchy skin, temporarily help relieve minor irritation and itching due to eczema or other condition. Safe for sensitive skin, no parabens, harsh chemicals. I did like this one. They say it's a rich cream, but actually I found the formula quite nice. It's not heavy, and what I remarked about this one, because I have red spots on my cheeks, they looking well more dimish in size and color when I use this cream, so I appreciate the cream for that point. Any other details about this one? It's vegan, cruelty-free, gluten-free, calming, and as I told you, helps with my redness. So I did like this one. I'm not gonna buy anything from those products, probably the mist, because First Aid Beauty is a brand that comes very often in beauty boxes, and I'm sure I have other creams in different sizes. So right now I don't need to buy anything, but it's something that I would like to buy if I wouldn't have it. Then we have, still from Glossy Box, we have a nail polish, and this one is the Oribe High Shine in Bloodstones as color. Is this one right here, and is the one that I'm wearing here. I'm wearing two nail polishes because I have two of them in this review. Here is the color, this color for the Oribe one, and I'm wearing another one on this hand. You cannot see a big difference between them. It happened, and I will tell you when I'll get to that one. I will show that in my nails again. Very similar as colors. This one is one shade darker than the other one, but it's a beautiful nail polish. I have another one, a red one, and I posted a picture on Instagram wearing this one in the Luxury Project Pen. Has a very nice formula. I think it's $32 for one of these. I didn't see this on their website, only on Amazon. Probably they don't sell this anymore, but you still can find it on different websites. Has a nice formula. I don't have any right now. I'm not wearing any top coat on top of the gel polish. I have two coats. I wear it before and it doesn't chip, it lasts pretty long. So I like this one and I do recommend it, although it's kind of expensive, this one. And actually this one in the Bloodstone, it's $48. Wherever I found it was $48. So the next product in here, it's from Nude Stick, and this one is Lip and Cheek Pencil in Mystic. It's a nude color, it's very creamy. I tried their products before. Glides so easy. Probably I'm not gonna wear ever this one for my cheeks, or maybe I should try it. I didn't, I have to admit that I didn't. Excuse me. I was wearing this one only for my lips, and I did like it. I used it before many times from the Sephora play box, the monthly box, and I was surprised to see that they don't have that subscription anymore. But anyway, turning back to this product, I did like the formula and I like the color. It's a color that I can wear every day. And the last product from Glossy Box was a beauty blender, and I just used this one. It's wet. This is the size when it's wet. Very bouncy, and I really like it. I like the shape of this one. You have the flat and you have the pointy part. I like it and I do recommend it. I found this one on Glossy Box and was right now it's not available for sale anymore, but around the holidays was $1.33, so was a great price for this one. Was sold out in no time, I bet, at that time, because it's a great quality. It was their brand, the Glossy Box brand, so I like that one too. I enjoy it. If you have one of those for the advent calendar, use it because it's a great one. Next calendar is the Elemis one, and from Elemis we have three items, and the first one, of course my hair is falling everywhere. The first one is the Pro Collagen Eye Mask, and is this one. I really like the mask. This one has such a nice texture. The mask itself has a great coverage. A ton of serum in this one. Also, it's to smooth, tightens, and hydrate. Contains hyaluronic acid, Padina pavonica, whatever is that, chlorella. They recommend to keep it for 20 minutes. I keep it probably for longer. I like the shape, as I told you. It had a great coverage. I'm not gonna buy it unless I will find this one with a sale, because it's quite expensive. It's $76 for a pack of six, but I did enjoy it. Then the next thing from Elemis is the Pro Radiance Illuminating Flash Balm. Okay, I switch it with the rituals. Anyway, the Pro Radiance Illuminating Flash Balm. This was an interesting product. And I will tell you a couple details about this one. This one is to brighten, smooth, and moisturize for all skin types, to use morning at night. Can be used as a radiance booster, as a makeup primer over your moisturizer, or instead of your moisturizer. Also can be blend with your foundation. Contains acai and a purple orchid. Has a light formula. I really like it as a moisturizer. I use it also before applying my makeup. I enjoy the product for both ways, and I think it works pretty nice. This one is not, I think has a fair price for the quality. It's $60 in the full size, and this travel size it's 22. But I enjoy it and I think it's worth the money, although it's quite expensive. The next product from them was the Elemis Pro Collagen Eye Renewal. It's another product that I did like. It's light as formula. It doesn't absorbs well. It doesn't leave any residue under your eyes. This one has claims to reduce fine lines and nourish. I can tell you about the nourishing part, about the fine lines. Probably I have to use many of these to see a difference. But anyway, this one contains Padina Pavonica vitamin B, C and E is a product that you can use morning and night, and I really enjoy it. It's almost done. I have a couple more usage in this tiny one, but I like it. There are not many eye products that I would buy, but this is one of them, so I do recommend this one. Then we had the Procollagen Marine Cream that we had a couple times before, so I didn't brought it again. The next calendar is the Giorgio Armani, and in this one we have the Eyes to Kill Mascara. When I tried this one first time in a bottle of mascaras that I have a while ago, I was kind of, after I finished it, because I had another deluxe sample like this, I miss it and I really enjoy it. I am wearing this one right now without an eyelash primer. The brush looks like this. Gives you length, gives you volume, gives you color. It doesn't transfer, it doesn't smudge. And I bought the full size. I have also the full size that I bought in Romania back in December. It's a product that I will buy again for sure, because it's really worth. Every time when I'm using a mascara that doesn't work very well, I'm using this one as a second mascara, or the Black Noir. What's the name for that one? Gosh, I will leave it on the screen. I always forget the names, but anyway, this is one that doesn't need anything extra, so I like it. I will buy this one for sure again. Still from Giorgio Armani, we have of course those pins that I'm kind of collecting right now, and this is a pretty one, the one with the lipstick shape. Then we have the Lip Maestro, and is the product that I'm wearing right now. This one is blush pink. It's Lip Maestro in 500. It's a matte liquid lipstick, very creamy as texture. I told you many times before that I'm not a fan of liquid lipsticks, but the Giorgio Armani ones and the what's the other one? The Giorgio Armani and the NARS ones are the ones that I like the most as liquid lipsticks as formula. So this is one of them and I really enjoy it. I will swatch it on my hand also, because also I'm not a fan of matte lipsticks. This is one that that I like, and is this one right here. And still from Giorgio Armani, we had the Si Passione perfume. I love the shape and the color of this packaging. It's so good, so gorgeous. This one is floral and fruit and floral, contained with rose and woody vanilla. I like it, but not as much as I like the one that we had the last month, the one with the green lid. I don't remember the name, because most of the names are very similar. I did like it. Probably I'm not gonna buy the full size of this one, but I enjoy it when it comes in the boxes. So this is all from Giorgio Armani. Then we have the Liberty, and in the Liberty calendar we had the Lazy Girl, and this one is Lazy Girl Hair by Sam McKnight. It's a dry shampoo, and is this one. Comes with those small shakers, and I like that point. This was an okay product. What I liked about this one was the fact that it doesn't leave any white residue. You don't have to blend this one a lot. As effectiveness, I think it's a basic dry shampoo. It's not something that I will go to buy. I have many others that I like more than this one, but what I appreciate, as I told you, was the fact that it doesn't leave any white cast. Then we have Dr. Sabah Pure Vitamin C Powder Cream. And this is a product that came, here is the box for this one, and came with two vials like this. This is the one that I use. They have some measurements here. When I used the product by the measurement, I thought it was a little bit too much. This is a product that you're supposed to mix with your serum or moisturizer. And let's see what other details I have here. Is to brighten and to add radiance to skin. You're supposed to mix with the serum or moisturizer. I mix it with, and of course they recommend their own products, right? I found in my collection this serum from Dr. Sabah, and this is the hyaluronic acid one, and I mix it with this one. The formula feels really nice. It's not very light when you mix the two of them. You have the feeling that this one doesn't dissolve. You apply this on the skin. One day I went by the measurement, and I think it was too much because it was kind of sticky after I used this one. I did like the formula, I like how my skin felt, but I am not a fan of mixing products. This one with the serum or with a moisturizer. So probably I'm not gonna buy this one. I will use the serum and this one that I have. Probably those two vials are gonna last me for how long I have the serum. And I found another serum like this that got the lid cracked, and I put that one in declutter. But I did enjoy the serum. I use the serum alone also, and I like it. And then I mix it with the powder. I like it, but I don't think it's something that I will ever buy. And also the price, it's kind of for five vials like that, it's 85 pounds, I think, or something like that, because I didn't find the price in US dollars. So enjoying when I have it, and that's kind of all. Then I had the British Rose rinse free hand wash. This was another interesting product, and this one is the Byredo, or I'm not so sure how to pronounce this one. I got a couple products before from this brand, and I love the scent of them. Always a great one. This one is rinse free hand wash. It's a cream actually. It's not a hand sanitizer. And I will show you the formula. This is it's a light cream, kind of like a gel, and looks like this. Really, really nice. Has a light and very pleasant scent. Beautiful product, but it's kind of expensive for what is. It's a good product to have it in your purse or in your car, but probably I'm not gonna pay. How much is this one? This is the full size 1 ounce, and it's $35. I enjoy it. Probably if I will see it somewhere with a discount, I will buy it. Absorbs in no time and doesn't leave any residue. So it's a very pleasant product, but probably because of the price and the quantity that you get in that one, I'm not gonna buy it. Then we had the still in the Liberty Advent Calendar. We had the duo from NARS, is the Orgasm Blush and the Laguna Bronzer. And I have also the blush in the 50 Shades of Pink Project Pan. I like the two of them. I'm wearing the two of them right now, and I always enjoy the color, the formula for NARS. And I do recommend this small size. It's $24. Then we have one more product, I think. No, we have another calendar, and that one was the Birchbox. And I think these are the last products from the Birchbox. When I'll pick up the products, I will show you the box if it's empty, and we'll take it out. I had the Dr. Jart Ceramidine Cream. This one comes with 5 Sera Complex to straighten the skin barrier. Apply by pressing on the face for better absorption. Plump skin, leaving it soft. I really like this one. One day I put a little bit too much and was kind of feeling kind of heavy. You need just a tiny drop, and I'm learning because all the creams, all the moisturizers are having different formulas. You need to find the right amount for your skin. So I did enjoy this one. Whatever I tried from Dr. Jart, I like it, and this is one of them. Also, I think it's quite affordable for the quality of the product. Then I had the hair product, and this one was the Mika Supernova Moisture and Shine Cream. I did enjoy this one. I read about this product. I used it before, and I use it on damp hair, but I read that you can use this one on dry hair too. So it's weightless conditioning leave-in cream that adds shine, detangles, stain, frizz, and protects from heat. Can be used on dry or damp hair. I like it because it let my hair soft and shiny. So I did enjoy the product. I have samples, so I'm not gonna buy the full size. But I like the Mika brand. I tried other products from them and I enjoy them. Then we have the Look Fantastic Advent Calendar, and that one came with I had four products in the Look Fantastic, and the first one was the Delilah double-ended brow groom, and comes with the spoolie at the one end, and here is the pencil. Comes with kind of a drop shape. It's very creamy and easy to apply. Here is the color. I'm wearing this right now, and I think it's a little bit too dark for the color of my hair right now, but I did like the formula. This one was in the shade, trying to find the shade here. I don't have it here. Doesn't say what's the shade. Probably it's a top universal or something like that. But I did like it. I like the formula. As I told you, it's very creamy, and the shape is very of the pencil, allows you to define your brows. So I do recommend this one. It's kind of expensive. It's almost $30. There are others that are working the same with a more affordable price. Anyway, the next product, it's a Nila Mascara product, and this one is a lip product in the shade Raw. It's a nude one. I would like this one to be a little bit more creamy. It's this one right here. It's quite a big pencil. It's a little bit longer than the standard size. I do like Nila Mascara. I like the color of this one. I will like it a little bit more creamy, but that is just me. And they say you can use it as a lip liner or all over the lips. Then I had from Prey, I think that's the name for this one. We have the Ageless Throat and Décolletage Cream. I like the formula for this cream. I used it before from a Look Fantastic box, and looks like this. It's very light as formula. Probably something didn't work well with the serum that I used under this cream, because I used it every day. Probably twice it was kind of balling up, and I think it was because of the serum that I used under this one. Because I use it alone and I didn't have any problem. But I enjoy the formula. I'm not gonna buy it because I have other neck creams that I picked up in some of my hauls. And I usually use the face cream on my neck and décolletage. So I don't think I need a product specifically for that area. But anyway, I enjoy it. Then we had the BioFX serum that I talked about a couple reviews ago a lot, and I had it in my favorites, so I didn't bring it again. Then we have the Fortnum & Mason Advent Calendar, and that one came with another nail polish. And this one is Cure Bazaar, not so sure exactly the name, but it's this color, and I'm wearing on this hand this one. Here I'm wearing the Uribe. So as you can see, there is one shade difference between them. This is one shade darker than this one, but the formula is great for this one too. I'm not wearing a top coat. They are pretty shiny. Of course, my ring light hits right on them and makes them looking even better. But anyway, I enjoy this one as a color and as formula. And those are quite expensive. This one is $24. This one's 48, even more, even better. But the formula is nice. Then I had the bath oil, and this one is the Olverum bath oil. Here is the packaging for this one. They recommend to use this one. Has a blend of essential oil for stress and relax. Use only half of a cap fold, 5 milliliter per bath, with rosemary and lavender. Well, one capful of this one didn't do much for my in my bathtub, because I have a big bathtub, a little bit bigger than a standard size, and I use more than they recommend in when I took a bath. But anyway, I enjoyed the scent of this one, and was really relaxing. So I do recommend this one. This one in full size is $52, of course, not the cheapest ones, but great quality. That's why I enjoying buying the advent calendars, because I'm trying products that I usually won't buy. Then we have from Sisley Paris, we have the Fito Eye Twist in Topaz, and is the one that I'm wearing right now on my eyelids, and especially on the outer corner. Is a darker color, looks like this. Sisley, it's very expensive, and here is the shade for this one. I would prefer something lighter, but this looks pretty nice. And this one in the in this size is $50. It's waterproof, long-lasting, matte finish, and that's kind of all that plant-based, with green tea, white lily, and camellia. Comes in 10 shades. Great ingredients in that one, but $50 for one eyeshadow pencil. Anyway, next product, we have a shampoo and conditioner, still from the same Fortnum and Mason advent calendar. And this one is the Bramley. We have the shampoo with lemon, mandarin, and rosemary essential oils, and the conditioner with the same ingredients. They smell really, really nice and fresh. I did enjoy the two of them. I used it last night. Leaves my hair very, very soft, enhance my curls, and also brings back the color of my highlights. And I really like that, because I didn't do my hair since last year in November. So I like the formula, I like how it smells. Although when you use it, you don't feel anything different than a regular product, but the effect, it's quite nice. I'm not gonna order, because they come from Europe, so, but I enjoy them. So next one in here, the next advent calendar, was the Harrods advent calendar, and that one came with a bath oil, and this is the well-known Aromatherapy Associates. This one was the City Serenity, a scent that it's not available right now on their website. Probably was a holiday edition, limited edition. I really like the scent of this one. I wish to be available. If you watched my if you saw my luxury gifts under 50 video, I showed you there a kit with a whole bunch of those in this size. I would like to buy that kit and see which one I like the most, but so far I enjoyed this one. Those are kind of expensive to buy them in a full size, because it's $73 for the full size. So anyway, but nice. There was a single one which was a very heavy scent, but the rest of one that I tried were really nice. Then I have the Living Proof Restore Mask Treatment. This one, it's for to restore moisture levels, damage cuticles, reduce breakage, help hair stay cleaner and longer, fresh, cleaner for a longer time. You can use this one after shampoo, leave it for 5 minutes, then rinse and use it once to twice a week. I remember using this product and really like it, probably a couple years ago. This time I didn't see a huge difference in my hair from this one. I will keep using it to see if it was the shampoo that I used before that didn't work well with this one, or just the product doesn't work for my hair as it used to do a while ago. I have the full size and mini samples like this from beauty boxes, and I will try it again. Then I have a face cream, and this one was Augustinus Butter, probably. And this is the rich cream. It's for dry skin or nighttime routine with vitamin E that hydrates smooth, leaves skin soft and glowy, and it does exactly what it says. Although it's a rich cream, it's not heavy, and I really like how my skin felt in the morning and look. It did look a little bit glowy, not very strong, but a nice texture on my skin and color actually. So I did enjoy this one. I'm not gonna buy it because this one is $85 in this size. This one alone it's $85. The full size is $170. It's a great quality, but it's another product for me that I'm trying and enjoy it. And then I have a Huda Beauty Demi Matte in Mogul. It's a liquid lipstick, and this one is $20. And here is the shade for this one, another shade that I really like. I wear it, I like it, not gonna buy because I'm not buying liquid lipsticks. Probably once in a while if the color blinks to me, but other than that, not really, because they come very often in boxes. Then we have the Rituals, and this is the last calendar. We had the candle that we talked many times before about that one. We had a face cleanser, and this one is Ritual of Namaste Purify Natural Skincare Velvety Smooth Cleansing Foam with Moringa and Holy Lotus. This is a cream as formula. Was really, really nice. I did like it. Was very gentle. This one has... I don't have the ingredients. Actually, the ingredients were here, the Moringa and Holy Lotus. This one is... almost $15 for this size. I didn't see any other size on their website other than this one. It's a mild as formula and not too foamy, and I did like it. I'm not gonna buy it because I have two more samples like this. As I told you before, I'm buying the Rituals calendar when it comes in sale because we all like it. So I have backups for that one. Then we have a body oil, and this one is the Ritual of Ayurveda Natural Dry Oil to Nourish Skin. Really nice product, smells great, applies easy. It doesn't leave that greasy film, absorbs in no time, and I did enjoy it. You know, I love Rituals, and this one is $25 in the full size. I think the price, it's well worth. I would pay probably more for this product than $25, but I think it's affordable comparing with the Hava one, which is $43 almost. So I do recommend this one, and it's a product that you saw in my last Rituals haul, and a product that I will buy again. So it was that one. Then we have a bar soap, and this one is Ritual of Karma bar soap with Holy Lotus and organic white tea. Smells so, so nice. I use it as a hand soap. You're not gonna find this one on the stores, only on the hotel supplies, and you can get 360 of this with $100. I mean, you can make gifts to the whole family and more than that. I enjoyed the scent of this one. I still have a little bit of the body mist in this from this Ritual. It's really nice. Of course, I'm not gonna buy 360 like this in this size, but I enjoyed the product. Then we have the Ritual of Namaste Hydrating Booster. This was a glass vial, which right now makes my hair raising up when I see glass vials. since my last experience with what was that one, the Babor glass vials, was a serum that you're supposed to use at night. It's anti-aging with goto cola and hyaluronic acid. You're supposed to apply this one before bed, and had a nice formula and was hydrating. So this is the last product that we had from John. Now I will go ahead and pick up the boxes for this month, and we'll see what are gonna be those, and if we have any calendar that will go out from the review. So I'm back with the products. Looks like one calendar is leaving us, and this one is the Beach Box. We just had the last two products in this review. It's completely empty, and probably I will buy this one again. Last year I bought this when it came in sale at the end of the year, when Beach Box had 50% of sale, and probably I will do the same with the calendar this year. So I enjoy the products that were in the calendar, and I think was well worth the 50% of price. You don't have to buy the calendars in the first day when they show up. It's way better to buy them with a discount. But anyway, let's see what we have left. And it seems like the Rituals Advent calendar will leave the review next month. Looking at the products that I have left, I see that in September we're gonna have the last review for the products. In the meantime, let's see what we have for the month of July. It's so confusing, those months are running so fast. Anyway, let's see what I'm gonna try in July and review in August. So I will start with the first one, and I think this one was the Fortum and Mason Advent calendar, and we have day 11. And day 11 comes with Be Silent, Nighttime Organic Temple Balm, Roman Camel Mint Poppy Seed. I don't know exactly what's this one, but this one looks like this. I will give you more details next time. So here is the first product. Then the next one, it's a Guerlain product. And this one is Midnight Secret. Looks like we have a bunch of nighttime products. And this one is Light Night Recovery Treatment. Those are so expensive. And this one comes with 0.5 ounce. I tried another Guerlain product, and I love that one. It was a serum. And here is this one. Then we have, still from Fortnum and Mason, we have day 9, and the one before was day 16. For day 9 we have Cult 51 London Night Cream. I told you we have a full skin regimen from for night. And the last item in here from Fortnum and Mason, it's day 1. Very, very pretty packaging. So here is the packaging for this one. And this one seems to be a moisturizer. It's Lucia Magnani. Not so sure if I'm saying right. This one is rejuvenating eye cream, but the packaging, it's so so cute. So this is all from the Fortnum and Mason. Now from the Look Fantastic, we have a first day 17, and we have an Emma Hardy product. This one is Moisture Boost Vitamin C Cream. The next one is day number 9. And we have a Noskia product, and this one is Renaissance Cleansing Gel, a product that I used before from one of Fantastic Boxes. Then we have day number 7, and we have the Ritual of Ayurveda, and this one is the same natural dry oil for body and hair, the same oil with that we have in this review. So I'm gonna use the product, but I'm not gonna review it again. It's a gorgeous oil. And the last product from Malo Fantastic is day number 10. And this one comes with the travel size of the First Aid Beauty Facial Radiance Pads, the one with 28. So this is all from Malo Fantastic. Now let's see what we have from the Armani Advent Calendar. And we have day number 2. And this one comes with a full-size product, and this one is Lip Maestro in 400. We tried the 500 one, and I will tell you exactly what's the shade next time, because I have only the number here. Beautiful packaging. The pin came with this shape. So is this one. And here is the color. I will swatch all of them next time, but the packaging is just gorgeous. So we have a full size product. The second one, we have a mini this time, and it's day number 8. And this one is, I will tell you next time because it's impossible to read. But anyway, it's something darker as a color that goes well with my nail polish. Another liquid lipstick, and we have another liquid lipstick, which is day number 1. Lots of lipsticks, and of course another product that I will tell you next time what's about, because the print here is just impossible to read, at least for me. And we have one more product, which is day number 4, and looks like we have a perfume, and this one is a very cute one. And this is it's a man one, the Pour Homme. So we'll see next time about that one. Now in the Rituals Advent Calendar, we usually pick that up, the products together, but having long nails, it's not the best thing to open calendars. And I picked up the Happy Buddha Shower Gel, which smells so, so nice. We have a skin product, and this one is a Ritual of Namaste Hydrate, another booster, and I think this, the other one was Purify or something like that. Anyway, this one is the Hydrate one, and we have two shower gels, one for her, one for him. This one is the Ritual of Samurai Sport Shower Foam. It's a man one. I will try it, of course, but goes to Colin. And the Ritual of Ayurveda, a product that I got often in Ulta free bags, and it came in many gift boxes from Rituals, so it's the last product from them. We have also the Elemis Advent Calendar, and this one comes with my favorite, along with the Elma Hardy one, the Elemis Pro Collagen Cleansing Balm, and of course comes with the cleansing cloth, which is this one. It has a really nice texture. I didn't use a balm for a long time, so it's about time. I'm glad this one came in this part. Then we have, that was day number 18. We have now day number 4, and this one comes with a toner, Balancing Lavender Toner. Then we have day number 1. And this is the Pro Radiance Cream Cleanser. Looks very similar with the other one, but I'm sure it's different. And then we have day 21. And this one is the Peptide for Plumping Pillow Facial, which is a sleep mask. This is a new product for me, so I cannot wait to try this one also. So that's all from Elemis. Then we have the Body Shop Advent Calendar, the Ultimate one, and we have day number 15, and this one comes White Mask Flora, which is a perfume. I never tried something any fragrance from them, so very happy to try one of those. Then we have day 22, which is something very heavy. it's a mask, a full-size mask, and this one is the Himalayan charcoal purifying glow mask in a full size. Then we have day 21, another heavy product, and this one is the British Rose body yogurt, which I told you before, it's a great product. I used before the banana one and smells so good, and I bet this one is the same, smells as great as the other one. The texture is light, and I like to use this one in the morning. And then the last product from this calendar, we have day 16, and this one comes with another skincare product, and this one, Japanese Camellia Velvet Moisture Body Cream, which is a deluxe sample, something that I didn't try before. And from the second Body Shop Advent Calendar, the red one, we have day 13, and in this one we have a bed bomb, which I told you before, those are so nice, and this is a product that I will buy again when I will buy the calendars. Smells so nice even in the box. We have day 12, I don't know if it's something in here, no, it's an empty box, so probably I picked up this product before I start the reviews. Anyway, one product less, so an empty box. Then we have day number 10, probably, no, this one is not empty, we have one of those loofah, smaller size. And the last one in here is day number 1, and this one comes, told you I'm lucky, comes with another face mist, the one that I just showed you in the review, is the Rose Dewy Glow Face Mist. I hope it will come again in the this year advent calendars. I'm not gonna review this one again, but I will use it for sure. And that's kind of all for the second Body Shop Advent Calendar. And now from the Liberty Advent Calendar, we have an Aromatherapy Associates product. And this one is the Distress Muscle Gel. I used this one before and it's a great product. Stronger scent, but very effective. Then we have, and this one was day 15, we have day 7. And day 7 comes with Lixir Skin Universal Emulsion, which is this one. Then we have day number 6. And this one is Aurelia Probiotic Skincare Botanical Cream Deodorant, which is this one. Let's see how this one looks. I don't think I use this. So this one looks like this. I didn't use a deodorant in a cream formula, so it will be something interesting. We used to get this brand before in the calendars, and they have great items, great products. And the last one is day 20. And of course comes with Anumoro Visa, and this one is the Queen of Hungary Mist, which you know I love, and I'm always grateful to get another one. Then the last calendar that we'll review is the Glossy Box one, and we have day 16. And this one comes with those hair ties. I have a couple of those in different colors. This one is the Invisibubble. I got the chocolate ones before and they really smell like chocolate. This one doesn't have any scent. It's a product that I always gets lost. Then we have day 13, which is this one. And this one comes with the Icon, with an Icon mascara. This is Black Magic mascara. I tried another one before in a blue packaging and I really like it. And my kid just loved them, this brand. Then we have day number two. And this one comes with something heavy. This one is Love Blush Mint Blurring Blush. Is this packaging. I'm not gonna try to open this one because I don't wanna have my nails flying everywhere. But I will show you next time. And the last item that we're gonna review is day number one from the Glossy Box. And this one, we have a big product. This one looks like a full size. It's Alterna Caviar Anti-Aging Restructuring Bone Repair Leave-In Overnight Serum. I love the color of this one. I like Alterna products. I always found them effective, so we'll see about this one. So that's kind of all that I picked up for this month. I hope you enjoyed the video. Let me know in the comments down below. I will see you guys with another video. Let me know if you use those products and what do you think about them. I very much appreciate your time and your comments also. Even if I'm not able to answer right away, I will do my best. But anyway, thank you so much for watching. I will see you soon. Bye bye.